First day of January 2020. We made it. We are special. We are loved. We are blessed. My name is Nicole Ivory. I'm the insurance broker of AI Mutual. Really excited to have you on this very important and special call. Today, we're going to talk about new year, new policy, new you, right? Everybody's on Facebook, social media, everywhere, talking about everything they're going to start differently this year, going to make a change from last year. Well, I'm here to help you with that, okay? So insurance is love. We're going to talk about that. Generational wealth, how do we create that? High society membership, we're not going to talk about that on this call, but definitely go to our Facebook page, also to our website to learn more about how once you become a client, you're automatically enrolled into the high society membership. We specialize in a lot of insurance products that can get you moving in the right direction for 2020. They include life insurance, annuities, long-term care, disability products, business owner policies, and will creation. So again, I'm Nicole Ivory. I am the insurance broker. What does that mean, insurance broker? How is that different from pretty much any other agent you've been dealing with? Well, basically, I have the ability to work with various insurance carriers. So I'm not exclusive just to one carrier, which is awesome because it actually benefits you in that I can pretty much provide you with the best experience possible to suit your own needs. Okay, I can tailor everything to you. Sometimes when you go to one particular carrier, they only have one range of products and they may not work best for you. But being that I'm a broker and I work with almost up to 50 carriers, so I pretty much can find something that works for you and your family, all right? I do have experience in property and casualty insurance, life insurance, as well as work voluntary group benefits. And of course, I have those great skills of team building, public speaking, recruiting, and finding exceptional talent. So even if I myself am not able to assist you directly, I can definitely partner you with someone on our team that can help you move in the right direction, okay? So why would you even want to partner with AI Mutual? Well, first of all, I got to tell you, we are a special group here. We have a wonderful business. You see that we are rocking and rolling on the first day of January. Most people are still in bed, still snoozing. We don't believe in that. We just think, first of all, this game of life is just too important to snooze it away. We know that every second counts. Every day we need to make things happen that's going to move our family forward to be successful in this thing called life. Because if not, if we just keep procrastinating and say, oh, I'll do it tomorrow. We'll look up and it's 2021. All right. So that's why we are here on January 1st, making sure that you stay committed to your goals that you have placed, your resolutions that you have announced to the world, maybe just to yourself. You've written it down somewhere. Maybe you've created a vision board, but we want to make sure we can help you with that. Okay. And then we don't want to just treat you as just a number that sometimes people do. You are actually going to experience this thing called insurance, okay? A lot of people, when they hear the word insurance, they start to snooze, they start to think it's boring, or they lose interest, right? Because they think it's too complicated. But we want to let people know that it's not complicated at all. We use, words and lingo that you can understand. We use examples that make it easy for you to understand, okay? When people try to complicate things to me, they're just trying to confuse people to try to get over on them. And I'm just like, just keep it simple, stupid, right? Just keep it simple. So this is the insurance experience, okay? We're excited to become your strategic insurance partners. And then, of course, travel alongside you on this journey. It is a journey towards financial freedom. What makes us different from other insurance companies? Our passion to see our clients succeed. We're not successful unless you're successful. Our ability to exceed clients' expectations. Of course, we incorporate the state-of-the-art technology and cloud applications that we're using in today's call. And then, of course, our involvement in the lives of our clients and local communities. So let's get started. What are we going to talk about on our new year agenda? Well, we're going to start off with 2019, right? A lot of people, if you've seen them on the timelines, they said it was the year from hell, pardon my French, they said the year from hell. So we're going to talk about the 2019 review. Why do people feel that way? Why did it feel like there was this big, huge, humongous cloud, you know, just hovering over us for the entire year of 2019? Why is everybody so excited that 2020 is here? So we're going to talk about all the blessings and prosperity that 2020 brings, okay? Because this is our year for blessings. And then we're going to talk about how does life insurance bless you? Speaking of blessings, how does life insurance blessings? Why is that so important? And then we're going to discuss our upcoming journey because we have 366 days because this is a leap year this year. So we have to make every day count. All right. And then lastly, if you would like to schedule an individual appointment with me, that's totally fine. And then I'll provide you with our agency contact information. So let's get started with this thing called 2019 review. And I'm going to actually pull up another document here so we can kind of recap why this was such a scary year. All right. So a lot of tragic items just started off wrong for us, right? First of all, we start off in January of last year. At this same time last year, we were in the midst of a government shutdown. Like there was nothing worse than being in the midst of a government shutdown over Christmas. But then for it to carry on into the new year when people are excited and, you know what the new year is going to bring, people were very anxious. People were nervous. People didn't know how they were going to pay their bills. People were actually getting evicted. People were behind on their mortgage. People were actually messing up their credit by taking out more credit. And for certain of these government jobs, you couldn't do that, right? So this was actually the longest shutdown in history, 35 days. That's more than a month. 35-day shutdown, 380,000 federal workers were furloughed, and then an additional 420,000 workers were even forced to work without pay. We saw them, the TSA agents, honey, they were letting everything through. It was very dangerous to fly at that time. And then, of course, this cost you and I, the taxpayers, $3 billion that we will never recoup, okay? So it was just kind of a total waste of time. Again, it started off 2019 on the wrong foot. And I always say how you start off is how you end. And so unfortunately, that's why 2019 was just such a horrible year for our nation in particular, because we just started off on the wrong foot. And then, of course, it just kept going on, and I'll just kind of rush through these. But kids in cages, oh my gosh, the inhumane treatment at the border. We actually lost 1,500 kids. Can you imagine if that was one of your children? They also experienced sexual abuse and child deaths. Like, I think there was 6 or 7 child deaths that were accounted for. And then Hurricane Dorian. I've been to the Bahamas several times. Many of my clients have. I'm sure you probably have as well. It was really devastating to see that it just, I mean, shattered the entire island. 70 people died. It was a Cat 5, the worst you can get. $3.4 billion in damages. They're still trying to recover today. A massive retail store closing. So like, you know, sometimes stores close and I'm not really that affected, but then they start closing all my stores. And then I kind of got a little upset about this, right? So Victoria's Secrets, you know, they had Payless, they had Gymboree. They pretty much had everything that they were closing this year. 5,000 stores have closed in 2019. Then also the restaurants. Again, some of these restaurants we do frequent, they're still around, but there were a lot of store restaurant closing. So you may have seen that there are some Carl's Jr.'s that are no longer functioning. IHOP, Starbucks, TGIF Fridays, Quiznos, Luby's, Polo Tropical. I know one for sure that actually had just built a building, you know, on a corner of I-35. And then the next, like, I want to say month or so, you're thinking it's going to open. Never opened. It just never opened, shut down. And I think now it's like an eyeglass place. So that was just, you know, kind of crazy. And then some other things that kind of really affected us, especially the African-American community. Nipsey Hussle's passing away, his murder. It was really tragic to our community because, you know, he was doing great strides. He was making great strides for our community by buying up an entire block in Los Angeles. That's a big deal, you know, because a lot of black people, when they become successful, they do not come back to the hood. They do not invest in our people. He was giving them jobs, especially people coming out of prison. You know, we know people from prison do not get jobs to start their own business, then they get back into that same cycle. So we're really excited about him, that he was, you know, he was very proud of his community and trying to bring it up. So that was very tragic for us. And also Botham Jean, you know, that was really, we were excited that Amber Geiger got convicted of murder. But then when she just got a 10-year sentence, I mean, that just really kind of put a damper on the celebration there. And then, of course, the murder of one of his key witnesses, Joshua Brown. And then lastly, the dropping of the civil suit for the city of Dallas. So, and then just to sum it up, of course, every year there are always deaths, but some major ones that we had was John Witherspoon, Toni Morris, Juice WRLD, Diane Carroll, John Singleton, Luke Perry, Christoph St. John, and James Ingram. Okay. So, you know, the worst of 2019, we're just going to say bye-bye to that year. Okay. Cause we're kind of done with that. We're ready to move on. So let's talk about our blessings and prosperity. All right. This year is starting off great. We're starting off on the right foot. Okay. You being on this call today lets me know that you are highly interested and just not verbally just saying, hey, you know, I want to do X, Y, Z goals this year, accomplish these goals this year, or make these resolutions. You're actually committed to getting things done. I always tell people, you know, just words without a plan. Okay. That's nothing, right? You like to say faith without action. You have to have work. You have to have put some work behind it. Okay. Just because you pray, right? That's great. But God can't bless you with the things that he wants to unless you actually put some action behind a prayer. So you being on this call today lets me know that you truly do want your goals, your dreams, your vision to move forward. And this year, not next year, not 10 years from now, not ever, right? This year, okay? So let's talk about the subconscious mind. I think a lot of people don't even A, know what it is, and B, don't even understand it. When I start researching about the subconscious mind, it just blew my mind away, okay? Because it's a under-tapped or pretty much a non-developed muscle that we have that we don't even use. And the powers that be strategically make sure we don't use it, because if we did, we could be 10 times, 100 times farther advanced than we are today, okay? So the subconscious mind is very powerful. It's like your mini army. Just think of it as your mini army. It doesn't ask any questions. It just follows orders. Every day, give your mini army orders to carry out daily, weekly, monthly, yearly, and then forever. Okay? Repetition helps this process. So for example, I have a 6-year-old daughter. I just truly believe in affirmations. And we're going to do some affirmations today. Every day before she goes to school, we make sure we just carve out 5 minutes because, you know, it's always busy trying to get the kids to school. But every single day when she goes to, before she goes to school, I make her do affirmations and she just gets carried away and just keeps adding things and whatever she feels like telling herself. Some stuff is really personal to her. But pretty much what she says to herself every morning before she goes to school, she states that she is beautiful. She states that she is successful. She states she will get 100s on her test. She states she will also become an obstetrician. And most importantly, she states that she is a child of God. She does this every single day. Why is that so important? Because it's going into her subconscious mind. That means when she has to choose between right and wrong, her subconscious mind is going to help her make the correct decision because it's going to say, actually, this is not helping you become an obstetrician. So I think you shouldn't do that. Or it may say, hey, this is going to help you become an obstetrician. You should do this. Choosing this answer on a test is not going to help you get the 100, but choosing this one is. So it's just very interesting to me how this, amazing how God has given us this gift and we just don't use it. So this year, I want everyone under the sound of my voice to just choose to tap into their subconscious mind, you know, to tap into that brilliance, to tap into that network that we each have built inside of us. All right. It's going to help us achieve our goals quicker and faster. All right. So let's do some affirmations today. And I want everyone to repeat after me. If you don't, if you're on mute, just go ahead. That's totally fine. I know a lot of people are on mute. Just say, I am fully present to every moment in 2020. In 2020, I let go of anything that no longer serves me. I am grateful for the strength with which I enter the new year. I am worthy of all that is good and joyous. I am attracting great opportunities this year. In 2020, self-confidence is my superpower. I choose to be free of the trap of my past in 2020. In 2020, I can achieve anything I set my mind to. I am attracting an abundance of prosperity and wealth in 2020. I step into the new year with courage and strength. And then lastly, with every single breath in 2020, I relax into divine guidance. Now I want you guys, of course, to come up with your own, or you can use these, but every single day, remind yourself about the worth of every single day. I think sometimes we just get so caught up in working, you know, 8 to 5 or 9 to 5 or whatever it is, and having to pick up the kids, drop them off and do this, go shopping or groceries. It's just like you forget about how valuable every single day is. What did you do that day that's going to move you and your family forward? Okay. Every single day this year, we need to be thinking about that. And there's a whole nother conversation that we can discuss on why there is such an urgency in 2020, why we should do that. But that's not for today's call. So you're going to have to tune in next time. Okay. And check out our website for that. But let's keep moving. So why is life insurance? How is life insurance going to bless our lives? Okay. First of all, we're not going to do a deep dive into this because that's not what today's call is today. This information is already posted on our Facebook page, and then there will be podcasts to do more of a deep dive into each particular product. Today is just to talk about the importance of life insurance, okay? A lot of people don't even know what it is, don't really know why they should have it. They think that they check the box off at work. Oh, yeah, sure, $50,000, $100,000, or whatever, or how many times is your salary? Yeah, that's fine, that's enough. Without really really understanding what those numbers mean, what life insurance is. Okay, so again, go online to the webpage, facebook.com/ AI Mutual, and then check out some of our past conversations about this. And then some other opportunities will be available in the near future for you to gain a better understanding. Okay, but let's talk about life insurance for a second. Some studies show that as many as 40% of the people that die in the United States have no life insurance at all. Just think about that. 40% of the people don't even have any life insurance. So that means when someone dies, right, they don't have any money to do the following that I'm going to talk to you about. And then over 50 million people in the U.S. are underinsured or don't even own their own life policy. Okay. So that's a whole nother conversation for another day as well. But I'm here today basically just to tell you, do not become a statistic, okay? Some of the benefits of getting a life insurance policy include, the first and foremost, paying your final expenses. What are final expenses? The funeral, right? Your burial. That's the first and foremost thing. I always tell everyone, your funeral is your responsibility. It's not your mom's, it's not your dad, it's not your kids, not your grandkids. It's your responsibility. And unfortunately, with this 40% of people who don't have insurance at all, they put that responsibility on their loved ones who may also be facing financial, you know, problems or have their own bills they got to take care of and don't want to take out a loan. Because I know people who do have to take out loans or having to scramble or having to do GoFundMe. It's just ridiculous. It's like a whole lot of begging for no reason. So don't be that, okay? And then also it helps create generational wealth. Man, generational wealth, that's something else that's not really discussed in the African-American community. But one thing I wanted to say real quick, since we were talking about Nipsey Hussle, he was already making money. Now, he wasn't like a Jay-Z or anyone worth, you know, $500 million or anything like that, but he was making his own money. So he was a millionaire already. But one thing I like about him is that he still took out a $1 million policy to make sure that his kids were going to be okay. And so that's one thing I always like to tell people too. Everyone's all on these social medias like, I want to be rich. I want to do this. I want to do that. Great. Start thinking like a rich person. Start thinking like a wealthy person. Even though people are wealthy and rich, they all still have their own private life policies. Okay. Why? Because it's like buying money. What you pay every month, you're never going to pay more than what you get out. That's just how it is. You're never going to pay more than what you get out. And they know that. So if you're trying to think like a rich person or a wealthy person, then you should own a life policy. And Nipsey Hussle was already a millionaire, but he still had a $1 million policy. So I'm just saying, and that's actually creating more opportunity for his kids now. You know, what if he didn't leave them anything? Then his family, you know, of course they would have his money and stuff from his own private record label, things like that. But just trying to get access to that is probably going to take a while, you know. But getting access to your money from a life policy is immediate. You know, within 2 weeks, you could have your funds, right? So I think that's genius, and I want everyone to be geniuses on this call. Another thing, too, is covering your children's educational expenses. As you know, education just keeps going up and up and up through the roof, and it's not going to stop anytime soon. Replacing your spouse's income. So important to do that. If you're living off two incomes and one spouse dies, guess what? Your bills are still based off of two incomes. And let's just say you're in a family where it's only one, you know, a breadwinner. If that breadwinner passes away, okay, now you're really in trouble now because there's zero income coming in. So it's very important that you have life insurance. And then also just paying off your debts, buying a business partner shares, and then paying off estate taxes. Okay, so this is how I'm trying to tell you how life policies can actually bless you. Okay, so, you know, the one thing I always tell people, if you don't have a life policy and all this financial difficulty comes your way, then you're taking 10 steps back. The whole point of 2020 being excited, having goals, having a vision board is that you want to move forward. All right. So think of your life policy as moving you forward, not only you forward, because you have a peace of mind, right? You can go every day, you can travel, you can drive. You know, everybody's dying in car wrecks. It's just crazy how everybody's dying. I was actually just, sad every time I look on Facebook and someone's always getting killed or killed by cancer or something crazy. Or when you go to church, people's always asking for prayer for, you know, this family or that family, or it's just crazy. So I just don't understand how anyone's living without a life policy. I mean, we see it evident every day. We're all not going to live forever. That's just how the system's set up, right? We're just not going to live forever. Eventually, we're going to have to leave this earthly body. So let's just make sure that you and your family are set up. And then guess what? Now you have the opportunity to bless others. You get to leave funds for your children. It's just not about leaving money. You teach them what to do with that money. You teach them how to live off of interest. You teach them how to invest. You teach them how to start businesses. You teach them how to set aside money for their kids and their grandkids. So that way, it creates generational wealth. Think about this. They keep talking about how the African-American community in 2053 is going to have zero wealth. Do you want to be a part of that? They're basically saying all African-Americans. That's kind of scary because I'm African-American. So are they saying that Nicole Ivory is going to have zero wealth in 2053? That's right. That's exactly what they're saying. And that's what they're saying to you as well. So you have to sit up here and figure out like, okay, how can this not be true for my family? Okay. Clearly, there are things out there taking place to try to make that true. So you have to individually decide the steps that you're going to take to fight against that. And one way to fight against that is by having a life insurance policy. All right. Bless your family. Bless those who are still living in 2053 and beyond. Okay. Let's talk about the journey 2020. We're going to take the road less traveled. We already say that a lot of people don't even have policies. People who do have policies, they're underinsured. What does that mean that they're underinsured? They don't have enough that's going to sustain their family. You know, they may have a $250,000 mortgage and only have a $100,000 life policy. Well, that's being underinsured, isn't it? Because guess what? When you pass away, whoever your spouse is, whoever gets that inherits that house is still going to have to pay it off, you know? And not just that, there's still car notes, there's still living expenses, you know, we just kind of named everything else that's still out there. So we want to make sure that we have the correct amount of coverage as well. And then we just want to take that road that's less traveled. This year, again, everybody's on a timeline today talking about they're going to achieve this, they're going to achieve that, and they're going to start off really, really strong, just like the tortoise, right? Just like the hare, they're going to start off really, really strong. But guess what? Another 30 days, shoot, it may not even be 30 days, another week from now, huh? For some people, it's going to start to slow up. Or some people may just want to take a break like that hare and say, well, you know what? I worked out this week. You know, I ate good this week. I'm going to just splurge and do what I want to do for the next 2-3 weeks, right? And then sometimes when it happens, we never pick back up on those good habits. I don't want that for anyone. I want us to start off on the correct foot. Get you a life policy in January. A lot of people went a whole year last year without a life policy. What if they would have died? How would their family would have functioned, you know? So I just think that we have to think about these things. I know personally, I have a great life policy. My daughter set up, you know, and then take it a step further and get the will created. So that way those steps are written. It's, you know, it's in writing. There's no confusion at any time. If people had questions once that time arrived, what your wishes were, get that all taken care of. All right. Trust me, your family's going to thank you for it. Man, your name is going to be good in the community. That's just what it is. You can actually give back to your community as well. So personally, I've actually, I want to tell all my business, but I have left, you know, some money set aside for some organizations that I also do care deeply about. You can also do it for your church as well. So I'm just saying there are many opportunities and ways that you can give back. Right. And then how to connect with us. So definitely if you want to take it a step further and actually go ahead and get it solidified by ensuring your family's success, let's definitely have a one-on-one call. So that way I can find out what your needs are. I also found out what your goals are. You know, you may want your kids to go to a certain college, receive a certain degree, live in a certain place or a certain neighborhood. You may want so much income every year being set aside for your spouse. Let's talk about it. Let's talk about what you're looking for so we can create a plan for you and get that taken care of. And then also how to connect with us. Again, so many ways to connect. Phone, email, our social media accounts. We can do, we can meet in person. We can meet on the web. It's just whatever you need to do. We're very flexible here. So as you can see, we have various office locations. We have Oak Cliff, Deep Ellum, Fort Worth, Plano, Waco, and of course the webinars. All right. So we just thank you so much for taking time on your first day of the new year to be on this call, to take a minute of seriousness, right? But then also to reflect and decide what you actually want from this new year. How are you truly going to move your family forward? Make sure you do those affirmations. Make sure your army is working for you and moving your family forward. Thanks so much for joining our call, and we'll see you soon.